Thank you for joining us on the next part of FTCR's 06 IP. We're now joined by Lazy Let's Play guest star extraordinaire, the other one.
Hi, it's me, Sierra.
Hi. I know how to save our world.
We don't have to change the path. So, Sierra, we're so glad you could join us on the most boring part of this LP. Nonstop Silver, this is the last part of Silver's story.
Great.
Are they gonna kiss?
To see Blaze die.
Spoiler alert! Jeez!
It's been 10 years, Gareth.
It's still too soon, damn it!
I've never played this game, so I didn't know that.
Oh.
Why don't you guys look at the environment they're in? Everybody's dead. You shouldn't feel bad about people dying in this game.
Great! So, Sierra, what is what was your first interaction with this game?
Okay, so my interaction with this game is pretty minimal, I'd say. Like, personally, when it came out, I heard all the backlash about it, but like, I didn't actually own the game myself. I was kind of like falling out of the whole Sonic thing since like Shadow came out before this, and I really didn't like that game.
How dare you? That game is a gem.
I could not stand that game, but so I rented it at Blockbuster when that was a thing.
Yes.
And I played like up until the Dusty Desert level with Sonic, and that's when I decided I was like, I can't play this anymore. It's just not, it is not good. Like, the glitches were more frustrating than they were, like, I guess, fun to mess around with. Like, they worked against you more than they worked with you. Like, the control in this game is like really terrible, and I don't know, generally everything's bad except the soundtrack. That's the one good thing it has going for it.
Well, then you can't ask Sierra the question you've asked every other guest, Gareth.
I can't, no.
But I do.
Normally I ask people, with the exception of the soundtrack, because that's what everyone says, what's one thing you like about this game, but I guess you don't have anything.
I can't. It's hard to come up with anything, honestly. Like, the design is terrible, the art direction's terrible. There's really... I don't know if there's anything really good to glean from this. I guess, like, watching other people exploit glitches and stuff can be fun, but, I mean, it's clearly really unpolished.
That's fair.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm having a hard time capturing Moltres right now.
That's because you used your Master Ball on Mephiles. Chef Bayard.
I kind of wish FTCR was at the same level as, like, Jerry Springer, so Sierra just, like, went on this huge bash about the art direction and stuff like that, and we're like, well, we have the art directors for Sonic 06.
Why would we have to be on the same level as Jerry Seinfeld for that, though?
No, he said Jerry Springer.
Oh, I thought he said... For some reason, I thought he said Jerry Seinfeld.
We have the art directors from Sonic 06.
We have the art director from B-Movie in the house, everybody.
Oh, God.
What would happen if they released Sonic 2006, but for today? You know, with a random game and stuff.
Gareth,
it would just be B-Movie.
Gareth, that's implying that.
iPad.
Oh my god. Gareth, that's
guys, what if...
Fuck me!
Let's movie speak on
no,
that!
No! It's gone!
You were saying wasn't even.
I was just gonna say that's implying that B-Movie had art and direction.
What if you went to play Sonic 06, but when you put it in your disk drive, it just played B-Movie?
That might be an improvement, actually. B-Movie, but every time they say B, you get sent to Crisis City.
I don't really like B-Movie because it's just Barry B rescuing the human girl over and over.
Especially after the human girl tries to commit suicide.
Suicide pact?
Hoppage.
The best thing about B-Movie is the character played by Patrick Warburton, who just has, like, He just has very, he's very human reactions.
He's very relatable, honestly.
To when she says he's hoping the bee sees through the human race, he just has this look on his face like, what the fuck?
I mean, honestly, that, isn't that how anyone would react, though? It's like, you're dating a bee. Like,
dating a bee.
Why?
You're helping a bee sue the human race. Wait a minute.
She dates a bee in that movie?
No, she's not. They're just platonic friends.
It's like implied, though. Like, I don't know. It's weird.
It's heavily implied.
All right. Yeah. So.
Wait, I would say it's heavily implied that Barry's in love with her. Not so much that human woman is in love. What is her name? We just keep calling her human woman.
Human woman.
Let's just, for the sake of argument, we could call her Elise.
I would love it if in the script she's just called Human Woman. like not human, it's Human Woman.
Which came out first, Sonic 06 or B-Movie?
I think Sonic 06.
We already made this joke.
We did? Oh, yeah. Remember, was TJ here for that? Remember when we said Tails is essentially the Matthew Broderick character from B-Movie?
Well, I'm just like, I'm trying to think of, do you think that they tried to make a Sonic 06 movie and then they were like, oh shit, we fucked up B-Movie?
B-Movie already exists. I'd love it if 06 started out as the movie adaptation game of B-Movie, but then Sega were like, nah, let's just put Sonic in it.
I'm really glad that we're constantly equating Sonic 06 to B-Movie, of all things.
That's because Gareth already shut down Aaron's 06 room connection.
Yeah.
The room?
Oh, it's okay, I have many more.
Aaron's like, this game's like Disney Infinity.
No, this game's like Seinfeld. Silver is cram.
Silver's still racist.
He hates blue hedgehogs.
Like, I like how this game is kind of, like, the antithesis of a Sonic game, though, because, like, it has the whole, saving Elise thing, and I remember that being, like, isn't that what Mario does? Like, saving a princess. And yet, here we are.
I like how this is a dystopian future when Seinfeld doesn't get revived for television. And Silver has to go back in time to convince NBC to put it back on TV.
Silver's still racist.
God damn it.
Think about it.
So yeah. This is a game. So when you got hit, five rings came out in the shape of a pentagon. Pentagon? Pentagram. Sonic 0666 is more like it.
Oh, shit, son! I don't get it.
Yeah, me neither.
Sonic 06 is the devil's game.
It's supposed to be actually Sonic 616, TJ.
Since this part's kind of dull, do you mind if I talk about someone that was trying to tell me a conspiracy theory the other day?
Go for it.
Yes, go for it.
So some guy at work, I wasn't paying attention, and the guy was like, you know what I'm talking about, right? I was like, sure, what are you talking about? And he's like, the moon landing. You know, they faked it. They shot it at Disney World. That's why they named one of the planets Pluto.
So anyway, I says to Mabel, I says.
I'll tell you later.
Knuckles is Uncle Leo.
Sierra, do you like McDonald's?
It's all right.
I thought maybe you'd be the one. You're not.
Were you gonna try and call me trash? I've been...
No, I was going to say that you like trash.
Well.
I like McDonald's and Smoovies.
I'm okay with... You know what? I agree with that blurb. As someone who went to art school.
Don't go to art school! Ah, beautiful.
Remember, if you go to art school, you'll just end up making Sonic 06 LPs.
Beautiful.
You'll end up in commenting over Sonic 06 selfies.
Yeah.
Think about it.
Is this like the last...
Man, I can't wait to play this game for the first time.
I was gonna say, is this the last level in Silver's story?
Yes.
Yeah, we're wrapping up Silver's story in this part.
Mm.
And then it's just Lost Story, baby!
How many stages does he get?
They all get 10.
Oh, really?
Mm. Yeah, they all go through the same level. Or are there 9 levels? Are there 9 or 10, Gareth?
Let's Wave Ocean, Crisis City, Kingdom Valley, Radical Train, Flame Volcano, White Acropolis.
Oh, there he goes.
Aquatic Base, Tropical Jungle. That's 8.
What are we forgetting?
It's already been this level's already been like 12 minutes though. I'm just like, goodness.
What other levels are there?
Oh, there's another one, isn't there? Did we mention the sand level?
That's it. Dusty Desert.
Oh, Dusty Desert. Oh, that's the one with the ball puzzle.
Yeah.
Goodness. Yeah, I can't imagine. Like, I could not play this game on my own. I think I just get too angry at it. Like, I love myself, so I'd much rather watch someone else suffer.
Well, someone has to love you.
Wow.
Yikes.
Yeah, Steven, I just looked it up online. In terms of the character stories, there's 9 levels, but then I guess Lost Story acts as the final level, End of the World.
Okay. So everybody but Sonic goes through all the levels.
Oh, good point, yeah.
Oh.
Because Sonic's dead.
just like his franchise.
Yeah, after this game, like, I didn't touch, like, any other Sonic game for, like, 7 years. I think by then Generations had come out, and I heard a lot of good things about it then, and so I was
you
like...
Didn't play Unleashed?
I didn't play Unleashed.
But at least it's hashtag art!
It's a really pretty game. I do...
And you say you went to art school, how dare you? Get off my LP!
You deserve to be in debt!
Wow. That's cruel.
Deserve to be in LP jail.
Smoovies, were we talking about how Sonic Unleashed was art in like the Universal Studios, the Nick Hotel hot tub?
Oh, fucking probably.
I thought for a second that we were gonna sacrifice Silver to the volcano god because he's a virgin.
Oh my god.
Jeez.
You don't know that, TJ.
I mean, have you ever met a time traveler who got laid?
Yeah, Doctor Who.
You don't know that.
Fry!
Actually, his name's not Doctor Who. What is his name? Did they just call him the Doctor, right?
Yeah, it's the Doctor.
Dickface.
I only know that because of Lego Dimensions.
Nerd.
Excuse me, Mr. Who?
First name Doctor.
Mr. Doctor.
Yeah.
This is exciting.
Actually, Mr. Doctor is my father. Please call me Dr. Doctor.
Kill me.
I didn't know volcanoes had elevator music.
Elevator music.
Well, you've never been inside a volcano, have you?
You don't know that.
He does.
Obviously you haven't, otherwise you wouldn't know.
TJ, your first time on a plane was going to Florida. You ain't been nowhere near a volcano.
Yeah, it's true. I don't like flying.
So you'd hate being Silver.
I do, already.
Let's talk about that. TJ, how was your first airplane experience?
I had a connecting flight.
Uh-huh.
From Atlanta to Orlando. And the second time going up in the air, I was just like, oh, this is great. This is fine. I'm not scared at all.
Funny hot dog movie.
And then, like, I looked out the window and I saw a cloud fly by. And I was like, oh, that's cool. There's a cloud. And then we hit turbulence.
Oh, yeah, turbulence. Yeah.
I was like, oh, shit.
Well, that's what you get for playing Final Fantasy VII on the airplane.
Yeah, turbulence has never taken down a plane ever, so...
You already know that because I told you, and you have felt very relieved after that.
But like I told Gareth, I don't know the difference between turbulence and engine failure.
Turbulence is when you just kind of bump up and down. Engine failure is when you just keep going down and don't go back up.
Oh, thank you. I feel better now.
I feel like they would usually, like, tell you over the intercom, too. Like, we're experiencing some turbulence.
We're about to die. Goodbye.
Nobody panic, but we're gonna die.
At the time, I was listening to Honeycomb Highway, and I was just like, now I can't listen to that song, because I'm just like...
Flight anxiety.
I experienced turbulence.
That's really too bad, because that's like the best song from that game.
It is a good song.
It is.
One of them is fucking good. Again, I've said it before, that sounds like the theme song to a 70s cop show, and I love it.
Well, it does. I don't
know. Honeycomb and Highway, the two cop names.
I like the,
Let's get him, Honeycomb, you said it, Highway. Well, right on.
I like the seawater Segway one, I think. Oh my god. Yeah.
Seawater Segue. If for some reason, it's a bad animation. For some reason, everyone calls it Sea Bottom Segway. And like people, I'm not insulting you, Sierra, but I kind of am. People can't fucking read if they think it's called Sea Bottom Segway.
Well,
because that ain't what the fucking word is.
What's a Segue?
I don't know.
I've never heard of that.
I've heard of it. I would tell you what it means, but I won't.
Me googling right now. Move to.
I was about to say if we had Chris right now, we just hear him type some more.
it's
true. Well, they
though,
say it's like a.
Jeez.
A transition. So I'm like, isn't that just segue? Like, when you're segueing to something.
It could be, but it's not spelt that way. There's no W in that track.
I didn't know Segway was ever spelled with a W.
The Segway versus Segway debate.
Yeah.
Segway Sonic.
The great Segway adventure debate.
The great Segway. Coming next year at TooManyGames.com, baby!
Segway!
Good old Sega the Hedgehog.
Let's see, Segway with a W is like the wheeled ones.
Yeah, think about it. I wish the entire level now was just Sonic on a Segway vehicle, like grinding on the rails.
Underwater, for some reason.
I can Segway on a grill. Underwater!
Sonic Blart Malkop.
Sonic Blart Malkop. Steven, you didn't get the Gamergate point!
Yeah.
Why not?
Aww.
I don't need that one. I only get the ones you need.
The only Gamergate points that matter.
Yeah, this game's like, you know, this game's like Unleashed. You gotta get Gamergate points to unlock the next levels.
20 minutes.
Yeah.
I know, right? I think we said this in when we played this through as Sonic and Shadow, but I would say this is probably the most boring level in the game.
Oh, it is, because it takes 20 minutes.
And it's like 20 minutes of just like sitting around and like waiting for things to happen, and then like you throw boxes at things occasionally, and that's like it.
And then you die.
Well, I mean, even as Sonic and Shadow, I think this is just the most boring level in the game, period. Just because it's an ugly looking level. The platforming is bad and the music is pretty forgettable. This is probably the worst level track in the game, I think.
I agree.
Yeah.
Ouch.
Although it's a giant fireball.
So who likes pie?
I do.
Pie's good.
Well, I'm glad we're all in agreement.
Yep.
But what kind of pie?
The only pie. Apple.
Pumpkin pie?
Hedgehog pie.
That's animal abuse.
Good. Fuck it.
Jesus.
Smoovies, do you ever have any intention to going back to actually playing 06 after recording this LP?
Absolutely not.
That's my boy.
Nope.
I love how definitive he is. Absolutely not.
No, that's... I didn't say, like, Amy in that cutscene.
Absolutely.
Absolutely not.
If I had the choice between playing 06 and saving Sonic, I'd choose Sonic.
Wait, what?
I don't know. I don't fucking know.
If I had to choose between not playing Sonic 06 again and saving the world, I'd choose not playing Sonic 06 again.
To play Sonic 06.
The fact that you have zero rings upsets me. I'm just so upset.
There's no rings. There's no rings in the section, so I don't know what to tell you.
It was... No, it was just really stressful.
Get over it.
Do you ever just get...
To play Sonic 06 to save the world, is that really the right thing to do?
No.
That was anticlimactic.
That was.
By the way, it just fell apart.
It just, like, crumbles.
I love how he's like, just as I expected.
It very slowly crumbled away.
Oh, it's Gamergate points.
Two hot daddies.
Great.
Silver, you suck at life.
Wait, I missed it. Can we go back and do that again?
Do what?
Like, not counting... Nice. The S rank. Not counting deaths. That probably took, like, how long? Like, over 30 minutes, maybe?
If you're not counting the deaths, I'm looking at the YouTube video and we're at 21:30.
Yeah.
Well, yes, but Steven, you sped up some footage, though, remember? I wonder how long the unedited footage of that level is.
Oh, definitely, like, 5 days.
Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, my God, what is this? Why does he look like this?
This design is just terrible.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
And which is why I agree with Sierra. I mean, like, we do, at some point, we will bring out the 06 designers to shame her. But, like, these designs are just terrible. Like, every character looks like shit.
Mm-hmm.
Iblis, super mega awesome Digivolve 2.
Fucking fish, go.
Yeah.
Like how long it took those to reach him.
Yeah.
This is like a really shit version of the giant baby Bowser fight at the end of Yoshi's Story. I mean, Yoshi Island.
I'd play that.
I'd play that for a dollar.
Now I want to see Iblis versus RoboCop.
Now I want to see Contra versus Robot Cop.
Robot Cop. I don't know why that tickled me so much. It's like the Korean off-brand version of RoboCop. Hello, I am Robot Cop.
Please insert girder.
So I think would Aaron and Sierra, would you agree that on a general scale, all the bosses in this game kind of
general
suck.
Scales.
General scales. would you agree that the bosses kind of all suck in this game?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Well, Aaron, you never finished the game, so shut the fuck up.
I played a lot of it, most of it.
Not all of it though. Have you played this boss?
I don't think I played this boss.
Then your opinion means nothing.
I think I played through Sonic and Shadow's story. Definitely Sonic's story.
But all the bosses, like, I'm trying to think of what, I mean, to be fair,
good job.
Bosses aren't exactly a strength of Sonic games in general. Like, most
of
the bosses tend to be
pretty...
Yeah, I was about to say that. Because I think, like, I could probably count on one hand. Well, no, excluding Generations, because I think, aside from Time Eater, all the bosses in that game are a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
If you were to remove Generations, I could probably count on one hand the amount of Sonic bosses I would happily replay again in terms of his 3D games, because a lot of them are just really quite bad.
Yeah, I'm trying to come up with some, because, like, I know Adventure was, I guess, the first one where they introduced, like, 3D and then boss fights, but even that game, it was just, like, really easy. Like, there was no challenge to fighting the bosses.
I would argue the Egg Viper is a pretty challenging boss.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That one gave me some trouble.
I actually like Egg Viper. The ending's a bit cheap, but I think Egg Viper's pretty decent. I think one of my favorites is in Sonic Colors, the ones you... like the giant ships that you chase in space.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I actually liked that boss quite a bit. I'd actually happy to replay that, but just a lot of and especially like in this game, like all of the bosses that are giants or whatever, you fight Iblis, they're just so boring. You just have to wait for him to like throw shit at you.
Mm-hmm.
It's so dumb.
Yeah.
There really isn't a lot of good 3D Sonic bosses.
So, Steven and Sierra, as the two hashtag art majors in this phone call, or Skype call, whatever the fuck you want to call it, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much does this design anger you? Because I'm not even that good of an artist, but even I'm like, what the fuck is this? What am I looking like? Why is his stomach made of lava? Like, what the fuck is this design?
I understand what they were going for. Like, his molten core is, well, molten, and his exterior is hardened lava, so that's sort of, like, what they're going for. But still, I mean, it just there's no creativity put into
it. Like, I don't understand, like, what they're trying to, like, base it off of. Like, his head looks kind of like a reptile. I don't even know. Like, there's no, like, solid, like, foundation for the design, so it just kind of looks like, I don't know. Just looks like a mess. Good job on the S rank.
Thanks.
You did it.
We saved the wild.
I'm good. Finally.
Piece of lava just like falls on Silver and burns his face off. Lend me your power. Eternal sun, the living. Again, we have another cutscene that's in-game graphics, but it's been pre-rendered.
I never liked how these ones look. Oh my god!
Steven!
Beautiful.
Please! Don't worry. My soul is already alit with flames. So, did this end in? Did like, thoughts on this ending?
I thought the song was great for it.
It was funny, Steven. I actually like the track they play. It's kind of like the Silver and Blaze friendship theme that it's used a few times over the course of his story.
Oh yeah, yeah. You mean a thousand miles?
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
Wait, what's gonna happen, guys? No!
TJ, are you attached to Blaze already?
Oh. Oh, thank God, he can't do it.
He just pushes her over the edge.
He just stabs her.
Wait, no.
I feel like I'm watching an AMV right now.
Yeah, Smoovies official AMV.
No.
1,000 miles, Silver and Blaze.
I actually kind of love this music to it.
Oh my god!
This actually does work. It's good job, Steven. It actually works pretty well.
Yeah. It's funny because in the song she says, if I could fall into the sky, do you think time would pass us by? And that's literally what's going on here. It's amazing.
I hate this stupid game.
I will say, as a disconnect between the game and the soundtrack, that there's various points in the game when Silver says, you're my friend. But for some reason, that cutscene track is called "You Are My Companion." They can't even get the fucking word right. I hate this game so much. And that was the end of Silver's story. I am surprised Sega, who are notoriously cheap, pointed up the money to actually license out that song. It's pretty impressive.
Can't believe it.
Yeah, I can't believe they got Vanessa Carlton on a Sonic 06.
Carlton Banks.
Bye, everybody.
Okay, bye.
Wait, which one's Smoovies?